Demi Lovato's life story is a disturbing one. Let's check it out. And there are some mind-blowing twists. Everyone knows that child stars have it rough, but Demi Lovato's life story might be even more disturbing than what we usually get. From As the Bell Rings to Camp Rock and all of the smaller TV drama series in between, she made a name for herself on the Mouse's best-known TV channel. But that can only last so long, and she hated it.
I'm not gonna lie, it was humbling for me too, because when I left, you know, it was like, you don't expect the show to go on without you.
Not only did the worst happen, leaving her with a sad hashtag MeToo story, but her journey wasn't over. More on this event later. When she hit the age that pushed her out of that specific industry, she turned towards the music world instead. It doesn't matter where you know Demi Lovato from, however, her story is still embroiled in tragedy. It starts, as it often does, with a long-standing history of drug abuse.
Because the last time I did an interview this long, I was on cocaine. It was called Staying Strong.
In 2009, she was the victim of school bullying. When she managed to befriend a popular girl that introduced her to a life of partying, alcohol, and drugs.
We experienced a lot of stuff together, drinking and using and growing up.
Well, it seemed like a step up from the social outcast status she had following her around.
Growing up, I had been bullied in school, and I felt like an outsider. I felt like an outcast.
But that wasn't when she got into the hard drugs. No, her first time using cocaine was actually when she had already started working for the Disney Channel.
My first time doing coke, I was 17, working on Disney Channel, and I was with a couple friends, and they introduced me to it.
Her usage also lined up with the fact that her father was both an addict and an alcoholic. She claims to have been searching for what he found in drugs.
I was scared because my mom always told me that your heart could just burst if you do it. But I did it anyways, and I loved it.
But her tragic affairs didn't stop there. The following year, when she was 18, Demi Lovato checked herself into rehab. This would just be the first time that she was in such a building. She checked herself in not just for cocaine usage, but for an eating disorder as well.
I called my mom on my cell phone and I said, I'm done, I can't do this anymore, pick me up. She picked me up from school and that's when my eating disorder developed.
The trigger for this was a fight that she got into with one of her backup dancers. This fight was followed by her sleeping the entire day.
And I slept the whole day.
She even canceled the remainder of her tour to enter into this program.
Demi was about to go on tour with the Jonas Brothers until she abruptly canceled after freaking out and punching one of her own backup dancers.
Shortly after leaving rehab, she was diagnosed with bipolar disorder. This did have its positives, though. She released a documentary and raised huge awareness. Demi Lovato has been incredibly open about what it's like to deal with the manic highs and lows that come with being bipolar, and how it has affected her career in the musical industry. But with every day that she spent out of rehab, the fight became more and more difficult to win. She relapsed and began sneaking cocaine onto planes, into bathrooms, and at night when no one was around to know what was going on.
Cocaine, and I'd bring it on airplanes.
How?
I would smuggle it, basically.
Her cravings were too much and she couldn't fight them off. Once more, she became difficult to work with. By 2012, she was back to being a heavy user. Directly before her performance on American Idol, she got incredibly drunk and invited two people into her hotel room. After this, she decided that a change had to be made. In 2013, she checked into a sober house.
There was a lot of embarrassment and a lot of shame. When I went into rehab, I felt like a failure and I felt like I had...
She surrendered in order to get help, desperate to find a positive change to make in her life. But she was not prepared for the struggles that came with being sober, or rather, the amount of struggling that went into staying sober. Every day was a new fight. She went in and out of rehab. But by 2018, she was celebrating several years of sobriety. Her eating disorders remained a constant struggle through all of this, only furthering how severe and difficult her battles were. Even today, she still grapples with eating disorders. But after 6 years of sobriety, she relapsed. And this time, it almost took her life.
Now with new details on Demi Lovato this morning, we're hearing the 911 call from her suspected drug overdose as she recovers in the hospital.
She was rushed to the hospital for an overdose that nearly took her life. It took until 2020 before she took to the stage again. And her dealer? He didn't care.
It was a flirty friendship, but nothing more. It kind of...
But the struggle to stay sober and healthy hasn't been the only misfortune tailing Demi Lovato throughout the year. It wasn't just bipolar disorder that she struggled with. She has also been diagnosed with PTSD, something that has supposedly come from her being famous. The hypervigilance that comes from constantly being tailed by paparazzi and having to perform for an audience virtually 24/7, being constantly monitored, constantly being forced to act as an almost an entirely different person, resulted in a fairly severe case of PTSD. This only helped her further her search for release through alcohol and drugs, a way of coping with and dealing with the stress of her lifestyle and untreated disorders.
Don't f*** me.
And still, that isn't the end of her tale. Demi Lovato's life has been filled with one tragedy after the next, a constant chase of sorts, a constant dealing with past trauma, except she didn't really deal with it. She buried her pain and suffering beneath drink and drugs, and just did her best to ignore it. In fact, until just this past year, Demi Lovato hadn't even shared this next piece of her life with the public. It's been her darkest, dirtiest secret for years. But in an attempt to cope with it, she's finally revealed the final piece in this dark puzzle.
My thoughts are, it's always been about heartbreak or struggles, and when they think of my music, they think it's heavy.
We touched on it earlier, but here are the details. When Demi Lovato was a teenager, still starring in Disney movies, she was raped by one of her co-workers. He received no punishment or crimes for his actions. He wasn't even taken out of the movie that they were starring in together. She was 15. Later on, she was sexually assaulted by her drug dealer, including on the night that she had her almost fatal overdose. Let's touch on that overdose a little bit more, shall we? Because a lot more happened than Demi simply being carted off to the hospital. On the night that Demi Lovato was assaulted, which was immediately followed by her overdose, she suffered 3 strokes, a heart attack, and even sustained brain damage.
I had 3 strokes. I had a heart attack. My doctors said that I had 5 to 10 more minutes.
This doesn't even begin to touch on the emotional trauma of such an ordeal, how it triggered her depression and anxiety, only furthering her sharp spiral into a dark descent. She took both heroin and crack cocaine, but neither caused her overdose. The real problem here was that both drugs had been laced with fentanyl, an incredibly dangerous drug that is being slipped into other sorts of illegal medicine and sharply increased the risk of overdoses across the nation.
It was only 2 weeks before I was introduced to heroin and crack cocaine.
It's important to note that even after her overdose, she still took heroin for some time. During quarantine, her life took another twist for the dark. Her at-the-time fiancé, Max Eric, broke it off with Demi Lovato. Supposedly, it's so they can both focus on their respective careers, but considering she's drinking and doing weed again, we can't help but wonder if there might be part of the story that hasn't been shared with the general public. This breakup came only 2 months after the original proposal. This was only 6 months after they started dating, and it made her realize something about herself.
That you suppress a part of yourself, it's gonna overflow.
It's really no wonder that people are waiting to hear more from her during the personal video series that she's currently releasing on YouTube and in talk shows talking about her past, her fears, and her hesitant hopes for the future. It's a very brave move.
I was in my hotel room at night. They would take the phone out of the hotel room so I couldn't call room service. Or if there was fruit in my room, they took it out because that's extra sugar.
The question then becomes one about her own determination to straighten out her life, a question as to whether she will finally name her original attacker, and a concern for whether she will finally be able to make something of her life, or if this disturbing history will continue on into an equally disturbing future. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to send positive vibes to Demi, and like and subscribe.